Hello and welcome to another episode of our World War II Weapon Guide. In this episode, the M1 Garand, an infamous American rifle that fired 30-06 rifle cartridges from an 8-round en bloc clip. The Garand's damage is high. You will be able to kill people within 2 to 3 shots, or 2 headshots entirely. Your range is also pretty good too, tied with the SBT, at 51 meters. Your penetration ability is high though, so if you want to penetrate people behind cover, you can clearly do that, but you're going to waste a whole bunch of ammo. Rate of fire is slow, thanks to it being semi-automatic. However, it is one of the slowest within the bunch. At 324 rounds per minute with the default, and with rapid fire it is slightly increased to 345 rounds per minute. Your hip fire is high however, so I suggest not killing people within point blank range. Either use your bayonet, melee, or use your pistol instead. Recoil is high and will kick upwards after constant shots. However, if you concentrate your fire and not shoot as much, then the recoil won't be much of a factor. Your aim time is at the default, at 250 milliseconds, and your speed is as quick as the others, at 95% of the base speed, which is default too. One huge weakness for the Garand is its limited magazine. You only have 8 rounds at default, although with the extended magazine, you make this weapon into the M14, and you get 12 rounds in total instead as well. But with your reloads, they are going to be quick and constant, with 2.1 seconds being your reload. So with the build of our weapon, we are going to be making this into a marksman class, able to kill people at medium and longer ranges, and you have to be accurate within each shot due to the limited magazine. And with the constant reloads, you're going to be getting killed entirely if you're not careful. First up, an optic of your choice. The iron sights aren't bad, but if you're not used to them yet, it should be the best idea to have another optic instead. The lens sight and the reflex sights are pretty good at medium ranges, but if you prefer a longer range and having a better sight picture, then the 4x scope is pretty much the most preferred. But second up is the grip, which will increase your accuracy at longer ranges too. So what it does, it will decrease your accuracy if you fire a lot, but you should be able to keep an eye on your fire rate too, so you won't be kicking all over the place. Other ideas should be extended magazine, or even the quick draw handle to give you better quick times to kill people. So for basic training, Rifleman is a really good idea to have. So if an enemy decides to give you a good old hello at close range, you'll be able to introduce them with a secondary weapon being either a primary of your own. And plus, you can either swap your weapons much faster too. Having an SMG or shotgun would really help within those close ranges. Second up, primed is a very good idea to have when it comes to accuracy. Not only will you be able to reduce flinch and maintain your accuracy, you'll be also to have another attachment on your weapon. And Forge is also a good idea to have if you are not going to be in the infantry division. So you're going to be wasting ammo a lot and you're going to be running out of ammo constantly. So resupplying through dead enemies is a really good idea to have too. So when it comes to divisions, infantry is probably going to be your best idea just because it's going to give you a lot more ammo. And will give you an extra attachment and the bayonet. The bayonet will be pretty useful if an enemy decides to introduce themselves in close ranges. However, when it comes to armored, that'll probably be your next best choice. You'll be able to soak up fire, grenades, stuns, like a boss, along with shock. And for equipment, you should be using either the S-mine or a smoke grenade. And a pistol is definitely recommended if you're not using Riflemen. So in conclusion, the M1 Garand is pretty equivalent to the SBT-40. Both of them have high damage, one of the best within the rifle category, and they also have impressive range too. You'll be able to reach within 2 shots at around 50 meters, and then past that, you'll have 3 shots to kill at other ranges. And it's excellent to use at medium to longer ranges. However, this thing has an above average hip fire, making this pretty poor to use at closer ranges. It also has high recoil, lower mags, and a lower ammo count. So, you do have to be pretty careful on the trigger and watch your ammo. And be sure to accurately hit your opponents more directly, even at the longer ranges. Do all that and you'll be getting impressive kills, and possibly get 4 kills within each magazine. Thank you all very much for watching. Be sure to like, favorite, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. And be sure to look at my Facebook page down below. And for our next episode, we are going to be looking at one of the newer DLC weapons. For which one? I'm not entirely sure. You're going to have to figure that out. Until then, Galactic Storm saying, keep charging, bitches.